Welcome back to Hello Nigeria. Now, our first set of top story guests today are two young ladies from Junior Achievers Nigeria who have been in the camp for the past few days. Now, we have the leadership camp, and they've been there getting trainings, meeting different media mentors and different people from around the different walks of life. Now, because Leila and I firmly believe in giving back and understanding that our role as young women is to help the younger generation understand what we've been through, our challenges, and to make life easier for them, we decided to have them not just tour our facility, but join us on set. We have Divine Joy Okongwu on my extreme left and Wana Daniel on my immediate left. Hello, ladies.
Welcome, ladies. Hello. It's so good to have you here.
How are you?
Thank you.
Have you liked seeing around the studio so far? How's the day been?
It's really cool.
Oh, that's good. What's been the most exciting parts of today?
The production controlling unit and how everything functions and how everything goes behind the scenes. Yeah. It's just like a magic on its own.
The
whole process and everything is really amazing. It's fun. It's something. It's a life experience.
So interesting. Is this your first time, both of you, being on TV?
Yes. So I'm super duper excited.
We're so excited to have you here.
Thank you.
All right. So let's start with you, Divine. How has the camp been for you? What would you say are some of the experiences that have been the highlights for you?
Okay, I'll start by saying that the camp so far has been wonderful and amazing. It has like brought to me, like, or revealed to me those my natural strengths, like what comes to me easy, those things that I never knew I had or I could do. So lately, the camp has been wonderful. It has been amazing. It has been adventurous, meeting new people. It has just been perfect.
All right. Wonderful. Okay, we'd like to hear what Wana also thinks about the camp, how it's been for her. We'll take a very short break. When we come back, we'll still be speaking with these ladies from the leadership camp. Now, in case you're thinking to yourself, how does this concern me? You're probably a mother, a father who has children, so you might have something to learn. Or a brother that would have a younger sister someday or a daughter someday.
Or someone who wants to have children pretty soon.
Exactly.
And you're wondering how to look after your children and what you need your children to do on the summer holidays. So don't go anywhere. We're going to be back in a couple seconds. This is Hello Nigeria, and we have two phenomenal ladies with us on set.
Divine Owana and Joy. Divine and Owana, I beg your pardon, are here with us. Thank you very much for joining us. So before we went on the break, Divine had shared with us her experience so far. Owana, how has the experience been for you? What are some of the things you learned?
Well, before I start off from saying what I learned, I would like to say this. I mean, shame on all of us who attended lead camp for these past few days. If by next year we are not going to be able to make an impact on the world. Because it's not only amazing, it's wonderful. I don't even know the right words to put it, because we have had ladies from different aspects, different sectors to come and talk to us. You know, they're like saying it as if, and there's one thing particular about everybody. They're like, we all wish we had this opportunity when we were your age, because obviously if we had this opportunity, we wouldn't have been where we are today. We have been higher than where we have today. So it's really wonderful, you know, starting from ladies from financial corporations, ladies from law, women in entrepreneurship, from the industry, entertainment. I've got to meet various types of people, you know. It made people realize the real potential, young ladies, young teenagers, to know what they can actually do. What is inbuilt in them that they definitely don't know that they have in them? You know, you might have something in you, but you need someone to tell you, yo, you have this in you. Because if nobody gets to tell you, and what Lead Camp does, it has told us, oh, it's really amazing. I mean, it's so amazing. So shame on all of us if we are not going to be able to change Nigeria. So it's too wonderful. So
you know what's even more wonderful? It's the fact that the both of you are sitting here, and I did not expect you guys to be able to speak this confidently. And it's so amazing to see young women who are still in school, you know, able to come on a TV show, a live TV show, and speak as confidently as you're both doing. That in itself is such a huge quality.
Yes.
I want to say a huge well done to the both of you on. But ladies, what do you want to be when you grow up? What are your aspirations? Yes, Divine, go first.
Okay, I aspire to be a lawyer.
Now, when we had this conversation, I've asked you this question before, and you wanted to be one thing, and your parents want you to be something else. What do you want to be, and what do your parents want you to be?
Okay, I want to be a lawyer, but they want me to be a doctor, like a medical doctor. But looking at my potential, looking at my talent list, looking at what I can do best, I don't see my life, I don't see a life, I don't see a divine, like in science. I don't see me wearing lab coats in the nearest future, attending to people, and I hate blood. Like, I hate the sight of blood. Like, anything. So I can't just take myself to the hospital, like, to be a doctor when I know I don't just like that. Just like me bringing myself to what I don't like, what I dislike so much.
And I'm very proud of you for being able to speak about this so confidently, Leila. These are conversations we need to speak about, because there are many parents who want to live their dreams vicariously through their children. Now, we understand that the first thing you need to know is your parents love you. They want the best for you. In their mind, to the best of their knowledge, that which they want for you is the best. But parents watching also need to understand that children have natural giftings. There's only so much you can force a child to do. You can force a horse to the river, you can't force it to drink. So as much as possible, I'd like to encourage parents to please help children harness their natural potentials and not beat them into what you want them to see.
Don't isolate them from their creativity. Not everyone, like Olive rightly said, we often see that parents try and live through their children and they want their children to go into things that maybe they weren't able to go into. But the important thing is to understand that before your child is your child is an individual. Your child has developed something for themselves in nature, in school, and they've come to a conclusion for themselves. The best thing that you can do as a parent is support whatever aspirations your child has. Wana, what about you? What do you want to be when you grow up?
Well, many things. I'm not focused on just one thing, because Lead Camp has taught me. I can't say I want to be a lawyer and that's all. No, it's not possible. I want to be many things. But before I go into that, before I entered Lead Camp 2018, I had this perception that if I want to study law, the Nigerian society of today, I mean, let's face reality, wouldn't allow me to be, because there's this case of meeting up the JAMB score, and maybe you meet that up, and before you know, you're switched, you know, the corruption in the society and everything. But Lead Camp taught me something. It taught me that you shouldn't let the society be an hindrance to your dreams. It taught me that you want to go for law and they give you maybe history or something not your other related to. They give you lemon, you make lemonade. You make the best at whatever they give you. So on my own perception, I mean, I would say my dad kind of had his say in what I wanted to be in future, but the pressure wasn't that much.
And what was that?
He wanted me to go into law. And at that time, I didn't have any perception of what law is. And I was like, no. But he passed on a few months ago. And when he passed on, I was like, oh, he's gone, so I can do whatever. Because my mom is like, just go for what fits you, go for what suits you, and go for what you make money in. That's her say. So I was like, okay. Then I started talking and talking. I figured out I know how to talk in public. I figured out I have this passion. I suddenly developed a passion for law. And it was like, I just love acting. It's my passion. I think it's my calling.
It's so, so weird. Like, I can see all of this in you.
The camera already loves me. So I was like, how do I merge acting and law together? But it taught me that
it's actually possible.
Like, that's my life you're talking about.
It's already possible. You can be at the camera and at the same time you're in the court of law. So Lead Camp has like taught me that go for what you want.
So can I give you a little advice, both of you? When I was growing up, because you also want to be a lawyer, as a little girl, I wanted to be a lawyer, but from the youngest age, I used to pretend to be a broadcaster. So I wanted to be a lawyer, I wanted to be a broadcaster at the same time. Up until the point when I was filling my JAMB form, I didn't know what I wanted to feel, because I wanted to be a lawyer, but I wanted to study mass communication. And my mother gave me the advice that changed my life. It worked for me. So I'm just going to share. I'm not asking you to do the exact same thing. My mom said, you can't be a lawyer by studying or by rehearsals, but you have the natural giftings of a mass communicator that you can work on, that you can brush on. Why not go and study this law that you've always wanted to study, that you can't get a certification just by staying at home? And then when you come out, you can do professional courses in mass communication and decide which you prefer. And that was what happened. So I went into school, I did law, and at the end of the day, whilst in university, I hosted like 90% of the events in my university, I hosted them. I was doing stage plays. I was doing poetry. So that way, I didn't even give up my entertainment dreams. Up until I was in law school, I thought I was going to practice law. But look at me now. And I'm living the life of my dreams, really. So now I can say that I have the best of both my worlds. As a lawyer, as an entertainer, as an actor, because I've done films as well, as an MC. And recently, I was invited to do an event at the MBA conference. So don't let anybody tell you you can't do everything. All right? Yeah. Okay, so now what would you say are your expectations for the future? What do we expect from you, rather, in the nearest future? I think I'll start with Wana. What should we look out for?
Wow, many things. You need to look out for many things because the world has to watch out. I mean, actually, there are 50 girls in lead camp, so I think the world has to watch out for 50 girls coming to change the world. Because what to look out from? On the aspect of law, I mean, I aspire to be the best lawyer in Nigeria.
How old are you now?
I'm actually 16 plus, getting to 17 this year. So, and also, I'm definitely going to hit the entertainment industry. So I'm so going to be there.
We're waiting for them.
I'm telling you. I'm so excited.
I'm already here. The camera loves me. It loves me.
So we're looking forward to seeing you in the entertainment industry. We're welcoming you, and we look forward to seeing you also doing your thing as a lawyer as well.
Exactly.
How about you?
Like she said, the lead camp comprises of 50 girls. That's 2018 set. And we hope to see ourselves, like these 50 girls, we need to do something out there.
What do we expect from you in particular? Do we think that in the next 5 years we'll see you as a doctor, as a lawyer?
5 years
no,
is too long.
No, for sure. 5 years.
It's too long.
No, I depend 5 years, on you have to go and practice. You have to study for 5 years at least.
But some people are going to actually start making an impact by next year.
You know what? Should I tell you what? Okay, so first of all, go on. But there's something about your attitude that I really like that I want to touch on. But go on first.
Yes, for sure we'll have to see a lawyer. Like, the world will have to see a very outstanding, outspoken, a lawyer with integrity.
I like that. And a lawyer with integrity. Not many people are with integrity these days. So please don't forget that if there's anything you take away from your camp, is the fact that you need to hold on to your integrity. That is who you are outside when everybody is watching, and who you are inside when no one is watching. Those two personalities must be one and the same thing.
Absolutely.
Leila, you're going to say something.
I was going to say something. You said you're 16 years going on 17. When I was 16, I had the exact same attitude as you. I was like, I can do everything I want to do. No one can stop me. If I say I want to do this, I'm going to do this. And I was in school, but I said, you know what? I have to make an impact. I have to make a change. I have to do something. So when I was 16 years old, I started my own NGO, and I started getting young women to come and volunteer with me. Let's work on projects. Let's do things at the grassroots. If you start something similar from now, I promise you, all the change that you want to make for Nigeria is going to be a constant ripple effect for the rest of your life. So don't let anybody say to you that you're ever dreaming too big. Don't let anybody ever knock your confidence, because you have so much confidence in you. You can sit here and say, the camera loves me. Not a lot of 16-year-olds can come on live TV and do that. And I really love it and appreciate it. So I want you to hold that and cherish that so much, because that is what's going to pull you through life. And I actually promise you that. And Divine, the same applies to you. If you want to be a lawyer, you are going to be one of the best lawyers Nigeria has ever seen. Have you heard of Justice Banjoku? Okay. Yes. Read up more on Justice Banjoku and what she's currently doing in Nigeria's Supreme Court. And I promise you, if women like that can stand where they are now and do what they can, those are the mentors that you will look up to that will help you to actually get there. We rise by lifting others.
Indeed, we do.
Have women in the industry that are going to support you. And I promise you, the world is your oyster.
Very true.
You will go anywhere you want to go. No one can stop you.
Thank you so much, Leila, for those wise words. And thank you, ladies, for joining us.
Thank you. Very quickly, in 10 seconds.
Sorry, how old are you?
I'm 15 going to 16.
15 going to 16, 16.
And I hope to see you modeling as well.
Yes.
Very final, in 10 seconds, if you had to tell your parents, if there was one thing you wished your parents knew, what would it be in 10 seconds?
That I'm doing fine in art class, and they'll be very proud of me when they go out there one day, and they'll be like, yes, my daughter is a lawyer, and she did this, and I wanted to, like, shift her to another aspect of life, but really, this is where she belongs. Thank you.
I love you, and the only child you have is going to make you proud.
Brilliant. We've been speaking with two amazing, phenomenal young women from Junior Achievers Nigeria Lead Camp, and they've shared with us their dreams, their struggles, challenges, and we look forward to seeing the amazing future that lies ahead of them. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much, ladies.
We head over to the news center. When we come back, we'll be lightening things a little more with entertainment. Dakpo will be joining us. Thank you very much for watching. Hello Nigeria continues in a moment, but time for a news break.
To enjoy more of this our Ogonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.
Indeed, money is necessary. Let's not even come and lie. It is really necessary. But another thing that is necessary is that you have to watch Hello Nigeria every weekday from 12 to 1:30 because we bring you the best of the best, the cream of the crop. Now, our very fantastic guest we have is a young man who did our music video. His name is Dapo, and he signed to Extreme Music. He's our guest today, and he's going to tell us some other things that are necessary about his life and about his music. It's good to have you.
Great to have you on the show. Yeah,
same here. Thank you, man.
Great
thank
to have you. So what has it been like under Extreme Music? What has the journey been like so far?
It's been crazy for real. A lot of people expecting a lot because we have Praise and Simi under the label. So be like, Simi and Praise are big. So they're like, what does he have to offer? You get? But I'm just trying to stay myself and do my stuff.
Does that put you under so much pressure?
It's normal. We're human beings. You get so. I'm just trying to just keep cool and do my thing.
All right.
And how would you describe yourself as an artist? What would you say that your genre is? Where's your best fit?
I call it Afrofusion and originality. That's basically what I'm about, you get me? So the Afro, just like fusing all type of genres to the African pepe, you get me? You get what I'm saying?
I was about to ask you, do you smile? But you just smiled.
African Atarudo. Yeah. Let's talk about your life before Extreme Music signed you. Had you been with any record label? Have you been with any record label before? Was it your first?
No, this is my first record label.
So what were you but doing? How did you get them to notice you?
I went for Project Fame, MTV, 2016, yeah, 2016. And it was crazy. I got to the finals. I was number 5th. And after that, I went underground to record a lot of songs and keep recording. And I sent a couple of songs to Praise. I was basically disturbing Praise every time to listen to my songs. And by God's grace, it just came around for me like this year, like a month ago, 2 months ago.
Now, the Nigerian music industry is extremely competitive, but what would you say is your game plan? Or rather, what's your strategy? How do you plan on becoming that relevant Afrofusion artist in the Nigerian music industry?
Well, I'll say I'll just be natural, just do my thing, just be original, and hopefully people appreciate the craft and they'll be cool with it. Okay, that's the game plan for me.
If there's one thing I take away from your conversation so far, is the fact that you're not just original, you're consistent. So you disturbed Praise until
he
took
notice
of
literally
you.
Every time, disturbing him every time. And there was this snippet I put on my Instagram and I was like, oh, gee, this is nice. I like the sound. I'm like, okay, could you just jump on it for me, boss, man? I was like, no problem. Send it to my mail. And that was, boom, just went that way, man.
So what are your plans for 2018? What do you want to achieve for yourself?
Okay, I just dropped a single, Necessary, and the video is out on YouTube. Awesome. I'm actually planning something in Unilag. That's my school. I'm planning a
are
movie.
You still in school?
Yeah.
What are you studying?
I took a break. Systems engineering. Mm. I took a break because I can't actually balance the two.
Yeah. So music, how long is the break going to be for?
2 years, possibly. 2 years. Well, if I break through into the industry, and by God's grace, I will, I'll think about what I'll do after that time.
Amen.
So I'm planning something in school and neighboring institutions in that area too. And I drop a couple of singles, like 2 more singles before the year runs out, and 2 videos, and hopefully a collab.
All right, so now you've mentioned that you took a break from school.
Yeah.
How did your parents react?
My dad is the academician kind of dad, you get me? But towards a particular time, he was like, okay, this guy, he loves this music thing. And I've been singing since I was 7, performing in church and doing stuff. They actually knew that, but... towards that time, was like, okay, after Project Film, was like, okay, this guy likes what he's doing, you get me? So let's just leave him and let him do it. I actually left the house, like, 2006, like, after Project Film, I just left the house, just went to the studio, to stay in the studio, sleep in the studio, record, do basically everything music-related.
Now, what we often find in Nigeria, and it's actually very sad, but it is the truth, is a lot of upcoming artists come into the industry. They may break through with one song, and that can lead to them blowing, and that's it, they're going to make it. Or a lot of upcoming artists come into the industry, and they just never necessarily make it to the top where they want to get to. Yeah. And the structure of the Nigerian music industry definitely has a role to play in that. But it means that everyone who is upcoming, especially now, has to have a niche. Everyone has to have something that's genuinely going to be their top selling point. Yeah. What would you say is your top selling point?
I just say, as I said earlier, originality and just being cool. Just
don't you think that's a bit broad?
That's broad. Okay, when it comes to my sound, I feel I'm versatile. to do almost every genre. You get me? So I just feel that's the basic point.
All right. Yeah. I think I can relate with him in a way. Because when I'm asked the same question, that's like almost the same answer I give. I always tell people I'm not trying to be like anybody.
Yeah.
I'm trying to be like myself. I'm trying to get people to know the real me. And if you like me, fine. I'm also making peace with the fact that not everybody will like me.
Definitely.
And that's totally okay.
No.
How are you prepared for fame? How well are you prepared for fame? Do you understand how fame is going to change your life totally?
Yeah, I know. Because after Project Fame, I wasn't able to do a couple of things I used to do before. Because before I used to buy a car, I won sports in my area. But after Project Fame, I realized that it wasn't possible again. Because they saw me on TV and like, okay, this guy won money. He won a particular amount of money, so we should get our own share. So after that time, I knew, okay, I can't step out as usual again. A lot of people, oh, yeah, Dapo, that's you, Afra. Let's take this thing, let's do this. And I'm like, oh. It's not every time you want to accommodate that kind of thing, but still you have to be natural and just be cool. Okay? But I just stay cool and do my thing and hopefully I'll get there.
And who inspires you? Who are your greatest inspirations in the music industry, both in Nigeria and also within the international community?
Firstly, I would say Praise, because Praise is actually, it was my judge during the season and it's really inspiring. I have Davido, Wizkid, Kiss Daniel, Mayokun is a big one too. And
I don't know when I saw him. I actually saw a bit of Mayokun. You know, looking at him, I think you
is it
a
the
bit
dress?
Of resemblance. I don't know if it's the hair or something.
Maybe it's the hair. Chris Brown and Bruno Mars. Yeah.
Okay, now beyond your greatest inspirations or influences so far in your journey, who are the artists that have supported you the most?
Supported Praise.
Aside from Praise, obviously.
Aside from Praise, at a point, Davido. At a particular point, before Project Fame, Davido did some things for me.
That's good.
Okay,
that's
good. We look forward to seeing that. Now, the kind of music that you do, you've called Afrofusion.
Yeah.
How do you get inspiration for your songs? And what kind of songs are we expecting you to see?
And
are
you a songwriter as well?
Yeah, I write my songs. Like this song, my first single, I wrote my song. What I would say is inspiration comes...
Why I'm asking this is... What kind of music, what kind of lyrics we're expecting from you? Right now, a lot of people are singing about bottles and about body parts and all that, you know, and we're seeing people who are singing songs that are encouraging an extraordinary, exorbitant lifestyle.
And the sexualization, there's so many things, the sexualization of women, materialism, there are so many things that are being encouraged in music and it's having a direct effect on children.
So are we expecting to see that from you? And is it okay to be very honest?
Yeah, relatable and inspiring content, that's what I'm about, really. Because my first single, Necessary, is about a particular period in my life where I was struggling. I said it at the beginning of the song and also telling you guys the money is necessary because it's actually necessary. Because that period of my life, I actually needed money and it's crazy for real, man.
Okay, yeah. So that means the floor
expect,
is still
yeah, we
open
expect good
for
flow.
You to still dive into the kind of lyrics that we have in this day and age.
I'll just talk about now. For now, man, just relatable, inspiring content.
And aside from music, then, what would you say you're also passionate about?
Football.
Yeah. So who are you supporting for the World Cup?
The World Cup, I was actually rooting for Belgium because my best player is in there, Hazard.
Hazard.
But they're out now, so I think Croatia has what it takes.
You're not rooting for France?
No.
I have no more words for you.
Who are you rooting for, Croatia or France?
Well, first of all, England just have to win that third place on Saturday.
No,
but
Belgium,
in terms
Belgium
of Sunday's match,
that, you know?
No.
Lots of people
like
found are not actually supporting
France
England because they said England
win.
Has too much mouth.
It's coming out.
Yeah, too much.
They'll be shouting, it's coming home, it's
I think
coming
it's
home
the media that just makes
you know
us
what
think,
it is?
Yeah,
I think people really envy the fact that there's something about British culture that I really appreciate. And in the years that I lived there, I love the fact that British people are literally just so patriotic. Do you understand?
Like
anything that happens in the country and the country comes together. If a bomb has gone off at X, Y, or Z, the whole country says, you think you can stop us, you're not going
to
stop us.
Totally,
football is on, everybody is out.
Yeah.
Even
I love
though
that
you are not
them.
Mentioning the fact that when England is about to play, domestic violence rises to
38%.
Exactly.
It's actually higher in some cases. It's actually higher
exactly.
in some
cases.
But this is not a
lose.
Domestic violence discussion. This
lose.
Is a football discussion.
In cases where they lose, domestic violence increases to about 70%.
Yes, that's what I just said. It's actually higher in some cases. It's not just 38%. Anyway, so on Sunday, I would definitely say France, though.
Okay.
France, so.
Our fingers crossed. I'm rooting for Croatia and you're rooting for Croatia as well. We look forward to seeing what the end results are. Thank you so much for joining us. How can people follow you on social media?
Instagram, I have Dakpo_official. Twitter is the same thing, Dakpo_official. I have Facebook, Young Don. Then Snapchat, DI_MMY4.
And how can they see your video on YouTube?
Just type Dakpo Necessary is there.
Brilliant.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.